Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for attending the last session. I'm going to present a new project. I call it olibc, and you can access the presentation, including the source code, in the URL. The URL is, I think, it's quite easy to remember. It just to send us the library name. I'm Jim Huang, and my experience was I was the contributor of AOSP since 2010. I already contribute for more than 50 contribution to AOSP. Also, I'm co-founder and the developer of LSD, which is the lightweight X desktop environment. Besides that, I was the developer of Linaro, working on Android platform. My employee history including MediaTek and iCube. So I'm going to discuss about based on my experience. I would like to talk about the idea to reuse the Android for ordinary Linux-based products. And so I will discuss about the C library toolchain optimization and the configurable runtime. Before this session, you can refer the related talks, including an Android Builder Summit. The LLVM Linux, this one is very interesting. And you can refer to Toybus and the memory allocation, including this afternoon K configure. So there are four parts in my talk. The first one is we are going to analyze what we can benefit from Android. Then we can make a new project. I call it olibc. So the project goal is to be configurable. And then we apply some optimization techniques. The last one is action item, which is which are something I didn't complete yet. Okay, so the first one I will talk about how can we benefit from the existing Android infrastructure, including Bionic libc, Dynamic, and some debugging facilities. So you already know Android is not Linux. But our plan is to take in something useful back to embedded Linux. yesterday, Rob has an excellent talk. He mentioned that Debian is the new long bash, and Bionic libc is just a long time to execute the new long bash. So the Bionic is very interesting because Google already modified heavily to fit its requirement. So why should we choose Bionic as a base for our new project? I think the first one is very important, the license. So if you compare some existing open source projects, GDBC is GPL, microcontrol libc is LGPL, Dial libc is GPL, Muscle libc is MIT, that's good. But if you check the implementation, you can see if you compare some target like the lattice ARM, MIPS, and Intel Atom, You can see GWC does optimization pretty well, and microcontroller libc does some simple optimization, but dial libc does nothing for optimization. Most of libc only does the simple Intel optimization, Intel architecture optimization, as mainly in Mathematica. So you can notice that the Bionic has better API coverage by versions, and it already can run some complex application like LibreOffice and Firefox browsers already. So I think the Bionic libc is getting better. Also, you can mention that Bionic libc already merges some contribution from several SoC vendors like Qualcomm, like TI, NVIDIA, ST Ericsson, and even Linaro. The upstreaming is, the progress of upstreaming is still very slow, but you can see it's a potential benefit. So if we can propose a new open source project to merge this effort, that should be very interesting. Okay, so the goal of olibc is pretty easy. Pretty straightforward. So first, to create a small, fast, and standard compliant implementation of C library. Also, we offer the configurable some option to configure the implementations. So you can configure from very small implementation to smartphone like devices. Also, we pick out all the system components, for example, benchmarking, validation, or even pre-linker from Android as the base. We can merge some security enhancement or fixes from other open source projects like NetBSD, FreeBSD, even some CVE fixes. As you might know from several vendors like ST Ericsson, NVIDIA, TI, and other SoC vendors, they all have Git repository or other open source repository. So it is really interesting if we can introduce all the enhancement into the single source tree. So let's review the programming model first. Assume there is Hello World program. So you can see you use a compiler to generate the EF image file, and then program loader load it to memory. So you can see some section like stack BSS data and the text. So for bare metal model, look like a broader or some simple non-OS environment. So it's just straightforward. But for some environment like Android, it's multi-threaded. So you can see it's going to be more complex. And if you compare Linux and Android, you will find that the basic component, the kernel and the library, are almost the same. There are just some minor difference. So our idea is we try to move something interesting, something useful back to embedded Linux, so from the right side, from to the left side. So let's review Bionic olibc. It is a small C library implementation, which is a mixture of NetBSD and FreeBSD. FreeBSD, the inclusion of FreeBSD is pretty new. It is about last year in AOSP master branch, especially for the libn implementation. Bionic olibc is majorly in BSD license, which has partially POTUS compliant, not compatible to GDBC, and there is no system file IPC support because Android engineers think that they are superior. I mean, there is a replacement called Binder IPC. And for AOSP master branch, there are mainly three target. One is ARM with stumble support and Intel x86 and MIPS target. In the past, there is even a super edge architecture support, but the architecture support was removed about 2 years ago. Also, Bionic olibc has a faster P3 implementation based on few tests. So if you compare the footprint, you can see GDBC, microcontroller libc, and Bionic. If we compare some older versions, you can see the quite a large difference. So GDBC is 1 megabytes, but Bionic libc is only 243. Bionic C has some limitations. So you can see there is no complete wide critical support, and there is no fully C++ exception support, and there is no fully C++ STL, and no fully POSIX 3 support. And if you check the source tree, you will notice that there is a very important description about memory map. Before Android 4.0, the memory map is fixed. So you can see the linker and the native library along with the Java applications. They are all have a fixed address. But after Ice Cream Sandwich, which is Android version 4.0, the memory map is already changed. So let's check the changes. Since Android 4.0 Ice Cream Sandwich, there is a new mechanism called AOR, which stands for Address Space Layout Randomization. So it's advanced security enhancement, which is known to protect system and third-party application from attacks. Also, since Android 4.1, there is a new mechanism, PIE support. And you can notice that the original prelinker, EF prelinker, was removed since Android 4.0 because the memory layout is totally changed. And since Android 4.1, there is an interesting feature called address sanitizer. Address sanitizer is a special memory runtime memory checker. So we can compare it with Wargreen So you can see it can perform some checking. For example, heap outbound check, stack outbound check. And the overhead is very low compared to Wargreen. So you can enable the feature. You can enable the feature and check some output like this if you have a buggy program like this is buggy because there's free. So system will dump this useful information. So you only have to add one line, this line, in file android.mk, and then address sanitizer will be automatic enabled. So this is a reference output. So you can see there is a buggy program. Is our range as memory access. So you can see the memory checker detect the problem for the address. Also, we can check the shared library implementation in Android. The older Android Diamond Linker has some problem which limits the number of shared library to 128. And since last year, finally there is a change which allows dynamic allocation. So you can see Android Bionic has long history if we come in from Android team. So it's from 2005. So 7 years passed, the Diamond Linker already has no such restriction. This is very interesting. And you can see from other open source projects like Mozilla or LibreOffice, how can they overcome such problem? They use extra hack copy of Bionic library. So so if you download a Firefox browser in your mobile phone, they are two dynamic linker at the same time. It's ridiculous, but it is a problem. So you can see from the above description, Bionic has some good part like this. This is good, and Bionic has some short part like this. And you can see about C++ integration. There are already several solutions. So if you check the NDK, you can see the comparison. By default, there is no C++. I mean, there is no fully C++ support. But you can use some extra package like STL port. So STL port does not support C++ exception, but support C++ RTTI, which stands for Runtime Type Identification, in current Android configuration. Also, you can use GNU STL package, which support both C++ exception and RTTI. To simplify the porting effort, we only provide olibc only provide STL port. So, and it depends on the wide character support in C library. Also, there is an interesting component in Android called debugd, which is embedded specific cache handler. So it can correct the crash data in certain file. And also, in addition, debugger-D can also facilitate connecting debugger to dying process. So you can correct the information before a process being dying. And it is a BSD license. How it works? Basically, debugger-D acts as a crash handler daemon. Also, it adds a default signal handler to each process, which handles any signal that generally the code dump. So you can think about the interaction between dynamic linker and the debugger-D. So once the default signal handler is registered, when application is going to die, so you can catch the information. So the signal handler captures the information and contact debugger-D. So debugger-D can use its built-in unstack unwinder to generate backtrace. This is very important for Android tracing because you have to couple with both Java and the native runtime. Usually C and C++. It's a common technique that if you want to trace a running Java program, you can trigger a signal to ask a debugger-D to capture the backtrace. And you can even ask GDB to attach. And Linaro toolchain working group improved the debugger-D 2 years ago. So the improved one can generate more specific backtrace information and even has better integration with GDB. Timber of Sony improved debugger-D. So he took the code base from Android and applied to ordinary Linux. So he created a new project called Crash Handler, which is based on debugger-D, but it can correct more information. So you can see Android's Bionic C is not only C implementation. It has some useful utility like debugger-D, like address sanitizer, and some enhanced security enhancement. And about the license issue, there are several articles discussing about the way Google work around GPL because Google use a script to pass the header file and generate the constant. Google claim that the general file is not copyright. But someone, if you are interested, you can read the articles, the two articles. It is still potential problem that the way Google to work around GPL license might be problem because they didn't do clean room process. But we think the way Google does is acceptable. I mean, you can check the license. So after olibc is generated, you can check some file, for example libc. So if you check the libc file, libc, you can see the complete license noticement, and the Linux kernel header is just regarded as the general information instead of the copyright material according to Google's statement. To eliminate the problem, we just follow the way Google does. So if you have any suggestion, please discuss with us. Okay. Okay. So let's think about how can make a configurable C library implementation. So we are talking about this area is C runtime, which talk to kernel as the interface of application. The first problem we encounter is the broken tool chain. So what's that? In fact, there are several utilities to generate tool chain. So you can see there is a closed tool. There is even closed tool new next generation. And many commercial tool chain like code sorting. So there are many tool chain. And there are even LLVM-based tool chain. But Android has only one tool chain support. The one Google engineer maintains. So if you want to replace the default tool chain to other tool chain, to replace the built-in Google tool chain with code sorcery tool chain, or other commercial tool chain, or even the tool chain you build from scratch, you might encounter the problem about the incompatibility. Before looking into the issue, let's check how tool chain works. So the in the diagram, the blue one is GCC, and the I don't know which color. It's the red one is bin utility, and the green one is C library. So you can see what GCC is just a compiler driver, which talk to several components like C preprocessor and CC1, which is the real C compiler, and assembler and S and a correct tool, which merge these objects, and even talk to LD, SLD to generate the final EOF image. And during the process, you can see some components like CRT, which stands for C runtime. And you might need some library, for example, the EH, which stands for exception handling. So it's not simply a program, but a collection of several utility. This is tool chain. So you might encounter any problem resulting from every piece of the components. For example, GCC front end might be crashed. For example, the linker might crash or generate the incorrect output. So the issue are as following. Code source tool chain doesn't use gold linker, as far as I know. I mean, the last year's last year's release, CSL 9. So it's still BFD based GNU LD instead of Golden. But Android original build flags are a bit aggressive, and it applies ICF, which is identical code folding, which is a Golden link only redundancy elimination. So you have to be very careful because Android has some aggressive flags. This optimization is good if your toolchain is well tuned and your source code is fits some fun bugs. You can use ICF to search. I mean, you can use ICF to search WebKit. You can search ICF. Oh, sorry. Oh. Okay. Oh, just ignore. So, because it's empty. I didn't take the correct example, but I have to remember that. In fact, Google's optimization has some bug, so sometimes it have to work around. Okay, I remember that. So if you search ICF, you can see the ICF flag is set to safe. ICF. But if you check the Git source tree, you can understand the original configuration is ICF2O instead of ICF safe. ICF0 can bring the 5% size reduction, but while ICF safe is not. So that is a problem that Google's toolchain always applies the aggressive optimization, and it changes so fast. But if you use the external toolchain, you have to turn off the optimization. But while you turn off the optimization, your code might not run, because a Google engineer always tests one toolchain at one time. So that is a problem which lead to the extra effort for olibc if we want to support several external toolchain as the normal open source project does. Okay, let's review the procedure to build an Android compatible toolchain. You have two ways to build toolchain. One way is bare bone style or bare metal style toolchain. You have to work with Android tree. I mean the full source tree, and specify all system and the bionic header, including several libraries and even Google's workaround. Also, you can prepare a standalone style building, so it just look like a traditional toolchain, like code source toolchain. But this is changing. If you check the source tree of Android toolchain, there is a repository called Android toolchain. You can check out this. There is a manifest regarding the toolchain, and you will find some interesting target. That is, there are more targets than you expect. So you can see the readme has a four target, but in fact the makefile.in has more configuration, and there are changes of fast. So that is a problem. If you take the second way, you have to take care the configuration and the header file, the library, and everything to be compatible with Android version. So after the analyzing, we give up to be fully compatible with Android version. We want to use the external version instead of the Android building one. So we just fix we did some hacks. I don't have enough time to talk about that. So it takes time to do some hacks. So let's continue. The goal of olibc is configurable and optimized. So there is a menu configure like system. So you can see. Like this. Oh, okay. Sorry for that. Okay. So you can enable, because you can choose the target and even enable some SoC optimization like Qualcomm. Qualcomm Crate or Qualcomm Scorpio, and it might imply some internal rule, for example the Neon, and you can even enable the debugging facility, even adjust the alignment for memory allocator, and memory. Okay, so you can enable the memory checking and some extensions, and the build process will communicate to Android's build system. We take some time to hack Android build system to be compatible with the K-configure like system. So you only have to modify one file. You can check this. So you only have to modify one file to press the description. Okay. So the last part is talking about the optimizations. In fact, Android already applies several optimization techniques. So the first one is the symbol visibility. So you can see Android applied this flag to enable linker object garbage collection. So it's known to saving some libraries, especially C++ library. Also, the Google engineer use genetic programming to figure out the best fit compile time flags. So it's very crazy, but it's also a problem for the external tool chain. For example, the default configuration of code source 3 is already based according to mental graphics. But if you apply these flags, the optimizer might crash or generate the long call because it is not the same code base of GCC. So you have to be very careful about these flags. Also, there is an optimization called FDO, which means feedback directed optimization. The idea is very simple, which is to correct your runtime information. So it's a paradigm called build run build. So it will build the first time and execute your program, and optimize. The second build will accept your profiling data and re-optimize again. It's called FDO. So if you check the source code of olibc, you can see FDO is enabled in our configuration already, but it's still experimental. It can bring some performance and code size, and even footprint optimization. It's a visible enhancement. Also, we have some dynamic link optimization. We improve. That is common for GDBC, but missing in Bionic. So we implement that GNU style hash and improve the pre-linking. So you can see from the diagram, it's normalized. So our final result is here. So the dynamic link time is shortened. And the symbol lookup is very, very, very small. So the to-do list is we want to follow the way eGDBC does. That is to introduce option group based on POSIX spec. So we can have better configuration about the features, about the extension, about even the standard. We can write down the detail action item of file some issue if we can support such option groups. And currently we are still working on these issues to resolve external tool chain issues. We already verified code source tool chain, but we still have some issue about the tool chain generated by build root or other tool like open embedding. I think it would be nice if we can collaborate with other open source projects like cross tool, build root, Yakuto, so on. And we developed some validation tool. My time is up. But we modify and enhance some tool. So you can see like this. We can perform some benchmarking. So for example, if we want to benchmarking the STR LEN implementation, you can compare GDBC and our olibc implementation. So we want to make it more stronger and improve the unit tests since we have to take care about the standard compliance. So you can compare another one. Is built by olibc, and we want to merge several more and more SOC companies contribution. So for example, NVIDIA, TI, and ST Ericsson. Currently, they do contribute to AOSP, but their contribution are always violate with each other. For example, Qualcomm has different Neon implementation. So Qualcomm's Neon optimization or Qualcomm's VFP optimization is not fitting the target of STLSN, not fitting the target of TI. So we want to build up a more flexible way to let the configuration coexist. And you can check the performance data. It's benchmarking, so you can see the GWC version compared to by olibc version. So you can see the throughput is higher. olibc is higher than GWC. Also, we want to merge some open source projects, for example, OpenMP support. The compiler already has great OpenMP support, for example, GCC and even LVN. But C Runtime has, there is room to integrate such enhancement. So that's our to-do list reference. Okay, I think my time is up.